compound targets enzymes that help coronavirus invade cells. Scientists from the University of California Riverside School of Medicine and the Sanford Burnham Prebys Medical Discovery Institute in La Jolla conducted a study to determine whether a compound that inhibits two specific proteases would protect cells from invasion by the coronavirus. Proteases are the enzymes on a cell surface that break the peptide bonds of proteins. Viral pathogens are only able to invade cells with the help of the cell's processes, including proteolysis. With SARS-CoV-2, the proteases must break apart the protein spikes that give the coronavirus its well-known crown, effectively changing its shape and giving it access to the cell's binding sites. SARS-CoV-2 has three cleavage sites where proteases can break down the proteins. The virus can then only target cells with the necessary proteases. Scientists need to determine a virus's cleavage sites and proteases to conclude if the virus can be transmitted from species to species, how pathogenic it is, and which tissues it can target. The researchers' study on SARS-CoV-2 was published in the journal Molecules. A previous study published in the Antiviral Research Journal suggested that most pathogenic coronaviruses make use of the protease furin, which is why the novel coronavirus may have spread so quickly. Instead of testing SARS-CoV-2, the scientists used the anthrax toxin because furin is known to also activate it and cleave the same sequence of peptides in the toxin and SARS-CoV-2 spike proteins. After the researchers confirmed that their agent named Compound 1 could protect the human cells from the anthrax toxin while in a dish, they experimented on mice. They found that even just one dose of Compound 1 could protect the mice from the anthrax toxin and improve their survival. The more recent study argues that additional research is necessary if scientists hope to develop compounds such as Compound 1, which not only inhibits furin but also the TMPRSS2 protease. The scientists also gathered evidence that the newly acquired mutations of the novel coronavirus allow it to target not just one cleavage site but two, those of furin and TMPRSS2. Mauricio Felecchia, a UC Riverside professor of biomedical sciences, said the latter is more abundant in the lungs, but furin can be found in other organs, which may show why the virus can damage multiple organs at a time.